Welcome to episode 23 of Diecast TV Channel.
We're bringing you an extra episode this week with another assortment of topics. Up first, Falcon has the scoop on the elusive fourth McDonald's Happy Meal toy. Then Cobra has in-store footage of brand new Matchbox single card models he just spotted yesterday. Some interesting ones in that lot. Along with some Matchbox 5-packs and a new Hot Wheels 5-pack seen last weekend. And lastly, I'll run through a number of reasonably old cars Cobra and I noticed still pegged at a supermarket. There's some real beauties in this lot.
Last episode, we covered three of the four Hot Wheels toys that McDonald's have been offering with their Happy Meals recently. We mentioned that if we found the fourth one, we'd show it to you in a future episode. Well, here we are, and here it is. It's a green plastic body plastic base car based on asphalt assault. It looks really cool in the packet, even before you place the stickers on it. Once the stickers are on, you're ready to try out its special action feature. At first glance, and from what we expected having seen the car on McDonald's website, one would imagine that the car is a simple pullback and release racer. There are rubber band treads on the rear tyres to assist with grip, and the car can deliver a good amount of power to the ground. But looking at the bottom of the car, it becomes apparent that this is not all it does. There is an off-centre fifth wheel mounted into the base between the front wheels, that when rotated, works like a camshaft, raising and lowering the front of the car from the ground. Well, that's very innovative. We reckon it's a shame they did this, as it ruins what would be a great straight-line speedster by making it continually bunny hop like a learner driver in first gear. Here's Cobra now with those brand new 2012 Matchbox cars.
I was at the warehouse looking to see if they had any new Hot Wheels cars out on the pegs, which they didn't, so I had a quick look at the Matchbox pegs, and hello, what have we got here? I whipped my phone out and snapped a few photos of what could be the first sighting of a further nine new 2012 Matchbox single cards. We have a black fire engine. Now, while I appreciate the stealth look of this, I can see some drawbacks if we're racing to an emergency at night in this scheme. An 85 Toyota 4Runner, which has a very colourful paint and tempo combo. A Jeep Willys concept. A Groundbreaker Bulldozer, which has some nice realistic high-vis yellow and orange paint. A Ford Transit Connect Airport Shuttle. A Caterham R500 Superlight. A Volkswagen Saviero Ute. A silver Aston Martin DBS Volant. And lastly, our favourite, a light blue urban tow truck. Earlier in the week, we also spotted these Matchbox 5-packs, which may or may not be new to you. We have the City Life 5-pack, the Desert Adventure 5-pack, the Jungle Adventure 5-pack, and the Beach Rescue 5-pack. Out of these, I think the most appealing is the Beach Rescue 5-pack, for two reasons. First, the cool red hovercraft casting at the top, which is something out of the ordinary. And second, the Jeep at the bottom actually has a tow bar to connect the boat trailer to, which means some fun towing action. And in the same store, we found this new Hot Wheels Police Pursuit 5-pack. They're all unusual looking police cars, and to be honest I didn't buy it, but it's handy to know it's out there if you do like it. Over to Eagle now to tell you about some retro finds.
You know how sometimes you'll be looking through the pegs and you'll come across one old car near the back and be like, whoa, that's already been there for a while. Pretty amazing no one bought it. Well, now imagine the entire pegs filled with them. That's what we found this week at a supermarket. 29 old cars, 18 Matchbox and 11 Hot Wheels. Some of the Hot Wheels cars are even sporting the 40th anniversary logos. Here's what we found. Matchbox first, Groundbreaker, Trash Titan, Chevy Silverado SS, Chevy Silverado, 65 Ford Mustang GT, Guzzler, Golf 5 GTI, Hummer H3, Austin FX4 Taxi, Tractor, Land Rover Discovery, Mercedes-Benz CLS 500, Tractor Plow, Honda Ridgeline, Nissan 350Z, Dodge Charger, Scraper, and Audi TT Roadster. Now the 2008 40th anniversary Hot Wheels. Hot Wheels stars Mayor's Manx. Hot Wheels stars Go-Kart. Surf's Up 40's Woody. Rat Rod's 204 Diesel Boy. And Rat Rod's 404 Way Too Fast. Finally, the remaining Hot Wheels. 2008 First Edition's Custom 77 Dodge Van. 2008 First Edition's Prototype H24. 2008 Hot Wheels Stars See You Later. 2008 Hot Wheels Stars Slingshot. 2009 HD Premier 70 Buick GSX. And a 2010 HDB Garage H2Go. Pretty amazing how all those are still warming the pegs.
That brings us to the close of episode 23 of DCTV Channel. Thanks to everyone for watching. Before we finish, we have a couple of special interest items. The first is something to balance out those real-life Camaros we covered in episode 20 and bring a smile to the face of any Mustang fans watching. Come on, I know there has to be at least one of you within arm's reach of a blue Ford Oval. This is a very unusual Roush 427 Ford Mustang, looking every bit like it has freshly come out of a Hot Wheels blister. We found it parked alone way over in the corner of the parking lot, probably to protect the bodywork from people recklessly opening their car doors into it. This car looks like it means business. The second topic to cover will come as a source of amusement to you all, but especially to our Australian viewers, as it relates to a table spread called Marmite that New Zealand proudly claims is superior to the Australian-made equivalent, Vegemite. Marmite is a black-coloured, yeast-based, vegetarian, savoury spread, a byproduct of beer making. It's typically spread on sandwiches or toast in the same way honey or peanut butter might be, but in much smaller amounts because it has quite a strong taste. It's a popular spread here, and some people can't do without their staple Marmite on toast. However, the nation has been shocked to learn that we're facing a national crisis, what's been dubbed Marmageddon. Basically, due to earthquake damage, the sole manufacturing plant for Marmite has to be deconstructed and rebuilt, meaning production will cease completely for about 3 months, making Marmite an increasingly scarce commodity. And what do the laws of supply and demand tell us will happen? Yep, you guessed it. As soon as the situation was publicised, people in their hundreds, many of them shrewd profiteers, began buying up all the remaining stock on the supermarket shelves. The Marmite scalpers have been flogging their full jars of black gold on online auction sites. And you would not believe the profits being made, many times the regular retail price. Now back to the diecast. Because we're doing two episodes this week, we'll have episode 24 uploaded over the weekend. Until then, happy hunting, everyone!